factor of unexplainable verbosity.
Oh, I like that, Jordan. Very good.
That's right from your file.
And his dubious career, now that he's cut his nose to spite his face, getting rid of Jimmy Hart may help him in his efforts for that never-ending quest for second place.
Now, I would have to disagree. Say what you may about Greg Valentine, but don't believe he's in constant pursuit of second place here in the WWE.
Especially today. I think he may be forced to eat those words and seek second place for himself. Greg the Hammer, a tremendous wrestler. Of course, genius is very good in his own right.
Well, yes, indeed. And since Greg the Hammer Valentine, though he say dumps the mouth of the thousand, Jimmy Hart, his popularity has risen immensely here in the World Wrestling Federation, and we saw clear evidence of that when he stepped into the arena. This crowd erupted. And listen to them now.
Yes, they certainly want to see Valentine really stick it to the genius. And since, as you said, Sean, he did dump the mouth of the South Jimmy Hart, Valentine hasn't lost a single match. And I'm sure he's not aiming for second place here this evening.
He went right after the genius. He's not here to mess around or exchange verbal barbs, that's for sure.
No, he's all business. The Hammer really is a great, great wrestler.
And he pinpoints that hammer back to the head of the genius.
Don't be deceived by those sort of silly moves.
You got right to the heart of the matter. I was thinking of another word, but...
Yes, because he really is a gifted and talented wrestler, and he will be very, very deceptive in what he does and throw you off your stride. Look at the dexterity, the way he can lift that boot from a standing position.
Well, he's rather limber, too.
Yes.
But it backfires. And they had one leg to stand on there, and Valentine swept it away.
Yeah. Valentine, extremely...
he is asking for... No. Maybe he was trying to go for a test of strength. Quite sure what he was trying to do.
No, but he did. He had a good move in mind, and it paid off. Oh, tremendous hit there by the genius.
Well, it's Valentine in the corner, but only momentarily. And that chop lifts the genius right off his feet. Hard into the corner when he comes out. It's a big hip toss.
And the Hammer really fired up now. He wants to finish the genius off. Obviously, that little poem at the beginning really got to the Hammer. And he's been all business since he came in the ring. A beautiful leg drop there with a trick. Ah, my word. He has the genius tied nicely. Going in, that's a form of an Indian deathlock there. Very, very difficult to get out of. Ah, punishing on the ankle.
Genius, I guess he was trying to display that there was some serious pain suffered there.
I don't know. But once again, he did succeed in pulling off the Hammer. The Hammer looked at that as startled as we were, and it's got him into trouble. He's lost his footing for a moment.
Genius attempts to go up on the second rope to do some damage. But as before, he's the one who ends up suffering all the punishment. Did a lot of that in this encounter. Valentine methodically stays after the genius, picking his shot. But the intellectual fires back. Not for long. Hammer looking particularly sharp this evening.
He is indeed, but I must admire the resilience of the genius. He's been hit with some of the heaviest shots that the Hammer can muster, and yet still the genius is in this match. He's not out of it yet by any means.
Well, he claims to be the smartest man in the World Wrestling Federation.
But there are times, Your Lordship, when I certainly question his intelligence.
And his ability, would you say that too?
And I am right now wondering why he ever signed the contract to step into the ring with the Hammer. As he has had some serious problems in this encounter. As Valentine continues to work away. Now he wants to set the figure for a leg lock. And he pulls the trigger. And you didn't even have to read the genius's lips to find out what he wanted to do there. He submitted